Saloon Talk is brought to you by...
You are confident. You are radiant. Well, hello there. My name is Judith Anna. Welcome to another exciting, mind-boggling, riveting episode of Salon Talk. And tonight, it's different. We are still in Spectra Salon and Spa. However, the discussion is going to be about the salon. The men that can't leave the salon. You're in a salon 5 days a week. What are you looking for? We have the women who spend hours and hours in a salon. Talk to the hairdressers. The nail technicians, is it easy to date? Are they hit on by these clients? And when they're hit on by these clients, what is it that they do? On the show today, we have hairdressers and nail technicians. First of all, I have Emma. I have the beautiful, beautiful pink lady. She's called Sherry.
Sherry, hi.
Hi. Oh, Sherry, are you single, Sherry?
No.
No, you're not single. How sad. We have Jojo. Joy.
Hey.
We have the superstar, Uma. It's going to be a great show. And then we have Aggie on the other side. Vanange. She's giving us some Thai power. So today, first of all, as I was scrolling through our social media, I noticed there was a conversation that was started up by a certain blogger. Apparently, there are certain men who go to salons pretty much 3 days a week. I mean, what's going on? And then, so I was having a conversation with John just before the show started, and she told me about this head massage that the women give the men. First of all, can't a man give a fellow man a head massage?
I don't think.
You don't think? Why? Is it? Because it's a technique. Is it a technique or it's in the... I don't know. There's a texture of your hands have to have a certain texture.
Yes, ladies always have magical touches in there.
Ladies always have magical touches in there. Eh? Tell me about it. So, don't tell me. You do massage.
Sure.
First of all, do you have a client that comes on a regular because of that head massage?
Of course I do. I do not even have like one. I have many.
That come? Yeah. How often?
Like 3 times a week.
3 times a week. 3 times a week coming for the haircut or the head massage?
Once for the hair massage and the other times for the, just for, once for the shave and massage, but the other times he only comes for the massage.
So I saw a picture where this lady had this guy's head on her chest close to her boobs. Is that part of relaxation? The relaxation process. I'm gonna love this one.
Because I'm doing head massage, the head contains, I'm supposed to massage the forehead.
Yes.
Then how do you expect me really to massage the forehead when the head is not here?
Well, the head needs to be here. The head needs to rest on the
chest.
On the
chest.
Yeah. All right. So,
the head is supposed to be on your chest.
So are these things you do for your boyfriend or just for clients?
Just for the clients.
Your main joy.
Yay! So what good is it to date a masseuse who works in a salon if she can't give you the head massage?
If my boyfriend comes here at the salon for the haircut, yeah, automatically I will have to massage him.
But if it's at home in his place, that is bliss.
Why?
Because this is my work and home. I don't have... Nah, thank you.
Don't you think your boyfriend needs that magical touch?
He needs that magical touch.
He should come for it here.
Yes,
he should come for it here in the salon.
Oh, by the way, John works here at Spectra Salon and Spa. It's a head massage at Twala Wala. So at least we've learned. So ladies, don't be mad at your men when you see them in the salons or getting a haircut and then the head massage, the head is supposed to be rested and rested on the chest. And now, so the allegations that through the head massage you steal people's men.
Who said so?
People. So haven't you ever massaged a guy and, you know, he starts to say I like you? Or
in that process, you exchange numbers.
But then I know one thing with me, like, no man can ever call you when you're doing massage and text you like someone responsible.
Oh, when a guy asks you out while you're doing massage, it's just the excitement. It's in the moment.
Exactly.
So you've heard. She says, I mean, it's normal for a guy to get a hard on while getting a massage because, I mean, duh, it's intimate. I know you're thinking of, should the man go back to the salon tomorrow? He needs the haircut. So, first of all, what do men love about the massage, apart from that whole thing? Like, it's relaxing?
It's relaxing. They feel good. It takes the stress away.
Bakubanza 5 billion, but you come and get a head massage and all of a sudden the stress is...
No, you relax for a moment.
For the moment, you forget.
Yes.
You forget about the date you're having.
Yes,
and then you relax, you feel good. I mean, you're like, oh, every time I get a problem, I should pop to the salon.
You should pop to the salon. My God. So salons are saving marriages in one way or another.
That's true.
Oh, my God. Okay, so John, tell me, still on the topic of head massage and all that, what's the weirdest thing a guy has told you or said, or you don't have to say the client's name, of course, but something they said and you're like, eh?
I was waiting for that part.
I one day massaged a man, yes. And this guy got like, he got high like seriously.
Had
never seen this lake before.
Like it was up like this.
It was very...
It was just a head massage. So okay, tell me, did they do just head or shoulder?
Head and shoulder.
This man began, like, went high even when I was just still scrubbing him.
Scrubbing what?
The face.
But let me feel your hands. He was what?
Dirty minded.
Oh, some men are dirty minded.
Yes.
So when a guy gets to that level before you even do the massage.
It was just a scrub and then he got so hard like...
Okay, the scrub is taken what? In circular motions.
Yes, I mean, but it's even rough. You know those...
It's a special touch. It's a magical touch.
I won't say the guy is dirty minded.
The guy is dirty minded.
I don't think so.
So for you also, you're the scrub kind?
Because I'm a man.
Yeah.
Let me try to defend the men here.
Yes.
Men, are we together?
Yes, we're together, man.
Uh-huh. Basically, what I understand,
yeah.
Some men have problems at home.
Yes.
Let's take an example, me and you.
Yes.
We have issues, eh?
We can never have issues, my friend. I'm that wife that will give you a peaceful life.
Okay.
Oh, go on.
Okay, the point is,
yes.
Of course, because we also need that care, eh?
Yes.
But really, I feel like standing up to him, I'm like, you know what, babe? I need the thing.
Yes.
At times, it's not sex, like, yeah, let me say it.
Yes.
But then, all I have to do is to come to the salon. So all that will happen, I'll be like, wow, I'm missing this at home. Just saying.
Yeah.
I'm missing all this at home. Eh?
Yes.
She's giving it to me.
Yes.
So I don't...
Yes. But Emma, wait. Emma, it's just a scrub.
Wait.
Okay.
Let me finish. It's my opinion.
Yes.
So it's just a scrub, like she's saying. Eh?
Yes.
But you've not been receiving this, like she's calling
it's
it a magical
scrub.
Touch.
Yes.
Eh?
Yes.
I mean, that magical touch.
Tell us of how rough it is.
Whatever it
is. Men like it rough.
They like it rough. You're getting it, eh?
Yeah, right.
So, I mean, guy is okay. He's a normal human being. Eh?
But yeah. To be honest, also, me, I don't understand that. How can I be giving you a face scrub and you're getting a hard on?
You know, it depends.
Wait, eh? Why are they touching? Eh? These are sensitive muscles. You're getting it, eh?
They're scrubbing. Talking about a scrub, not a massage.
Jeez, I know it is a scrub, I mean.
You're scrubbing my face. These are sensitive muscles.
Yes.
You get? So... Let's say we had a situation at night.
Yes.
You know.
So you're taking you're bringing.
No. It's not that. Let's say we had a situation at night.
Yes.
Me and my woman. Let's say I wanted it and she said no.
Yes.
You get?
Yes. I mean, very early in the morning.
Joanne.
You come to the salon very early in the morning.
Yeah,
okay.
I come to the salon early in the morning.
Yes.
Then Joanne with her magical touch, soft hands, she touches my sensitive.
She's touching you, but the scrub is rough. What's wrong with men?
What if I want it rough?
Huh? What if you want it rough?
Yeah, I want it rough.
Okay, the point here is, like she said, he came with a dirty mind. He didn't come with a dirty mind.
It's not a dirty mind. Yeah.
He came to just chill out. Just,
you stimulated that.
Just be understanding.
How can we term this? What's the true definition of his mind?
I mean, because it's tricky, to be honest.
No, it's no, Joan, it's like you didn't take time to understand that
okay,
man.
So back to Joan. Okay.
Normal, like, was he normal?
He's normal.
100% normal. 100%.
So 100%. It's normal to get a hard one while receiving a fist cramp.
It's okay.
It's okay, yeah.
At that moment, what was going through your head? What did you tell him? What did you stop? Did you go?
I didn't tell him anything.
Did you stop?
I did not stop.
You went on.
She was enjoying it.
Wow!
Yeah, she was enjoying it.
So you didn't say anything. Did he try to cover and like disguise?
I'm not completed what my statement. Okay, I was telling
you. Complete my.
So I'm the scrub. I brought him to the sink.
Yeah, you brought him to the sink.
So what should we went back? Yes. Immediately, I was still applying the aftershave.
The aftershave.
This man acted so weirdly. Do you know what he did?
What?
He began to touch her.
He began to touch you, your hands.
I don't. He began shivering.
She was like, ooh. Just an aftershave.
Yeah, I think. Man.
But Joel, what kind of hands do you have? No.
I did not massage him.
You did not
massage him? I never.
So all this happened without a massage, just you applying aftershave. And
this was his first time here, so it maybe he didn't even know that we even do massage here because I was scared.
So what if it went that far?
John, what kind of hands do you have, Vanang? Are these things you're taught? You're
no, it's not like not every man like acts like he did.
You applied aftershave and the guy, the electricity hit him. Yaka was like prr, pa, ta ta ta, tra. Oh my God! We learn a thing or two every day. My. Ah! Yes, I've learned from men that even applying a face scrub is enough to get the guy there. Yeah, for some men.
Some men.
Man, men are into some funny things. Today, it's all about the salon, the hairdressers, the nail technicians, all the things that they go through. We're going to discuss that today. So ladies, gentlemen, buckle up. It's going to be a bumpy ride.
Salon Talk is brought to you by...
You are confident. You are radiant.